of the things that always amazes my Juilliard students who come out of the arguably the number one conservatory in the world, and maybe the best at whatever they're doing in the world by the time they came out. It's also the hardest school to get into, is and they're ready to take a job, and everybody assumes that when they graduate, they'll be people will be throwing rose petals at them, and an agent will tap them on the shoulder and say, "I've got a $200,000 job for you at such and such a place." But that doesn't really happen. What I tell the students is that you have to start thinking in terms of running a business. The likelihood is even with all of the great skill you have, you've got to learn to be a business person, or you've got to have the resources of somebody who does know how to run a business working with you, because otherwise pretty much you're not going to make it. And that skill of running a business is one that has been pretty well honed and developed well thought through by organizations like the American Management Association and business schools all over the world. But you've got to learn that, and you can't be afraid of it. So we spend the first couple chapters first talking about the industry itself. You know, the performing arts industry in America is actually very small. In terms of revenue, Starbucks is bigger than the performing arts industry in America. So it's small, it's highly competitive, and unless you're ready to think in terms of running a small business, you're likely not to get from A to B, no matter how much talent you have. So what I say to the people that I'm involved with who are really brilliant performers is that it's not fundraising, it's friend raising. You have to make friends. You have your own friends, and that's a good base, but you have to make friends inside the organizations where people see you perform. So I say, when you're out performing and when the play or the dance or the symphony is over, the music is over, people applaud. You don't go back to the dressing room and collapse. You look at who was applauding and you come to them before they leave, and you become their friends. Because likely they're older people, likely they've got some money in their wallet, and even billionaires who run these huge businesses and enterprises are blown away by people with amazing talent. And it's amazing, and you can convert that amazement and that respect into money to help support your work. So those are just some of the techniques. And of course, in our book, we talk about many more. But we also talk about the pitfalls. You know, you can spend an awful lot of time raising money and get nowhere. Or you spend a lot of time raising money and doing events and actually losing money. You've got to be very careful. It's quite a science.